Welcome back to the OpenVINO channel. In all the videos so far, we've talked about image and video processing. But OpenVINO can help you accelerate audio, NLP, and many other usages. This video is an ultra-fast introduction to audio processing. There are many better and more comprehensive full tutorials. This is really just to get you started. Before talking about audio, a quick reminder on image processing. Here are 2 pixels of an image. These pixels cannot help us much with understanding the full image. Even if we have all the pixels, it is not enough, because if we move the image by 1 pixel to any side, the way the computer represents this image is totally different. And if the image is scaled, bigger or smaller, rotated, or gone through any such simple transformation, it's totally different image as represented in memory. What we need is invariance to all these transformations. So the first layers of the neural networks we usually use are doing exactly this. We're taking the original image, and the first layer or layers usually implement convolutions and other operations to extract features from the image. The first layer of features will sometimes look like this, edges. The second layers will extract higher level features, maybe shapes like circles, corners, and so on. So every layer of the first layers is extracting more and more features of the image. Hopefully, these features are invariant to all kinds of scaling, rotating, and so on. And we apply filters with multiple sizes and basically extract features at few scales or rotations. And now, the fully connected layers can determine if this is a flower based on the combination of all the features that were extracted. And this is AI for vision in a nutshell. The same applies for audio signals. Just one tone of the audio is not going to help us a lot, and not even the full signal at the time domain. We need, just like for the image processing, to extract audio invariant features, and only then try to actually detect or classify the audio. So let's talk about extracting audio features. This is a 1 kHz simple sine wave, and this is how it sounds. Audio is a signal in the time domain. A signal is sampled and quantized. We are working with digital signals. This is a 2 kHz simple sine wave, and this is how it sounds. Our ears are sensitive to audio signals in the time and frequency domains. Processing audio in the time domain alone is difficult, so the frequency domain representation of a signal reveals several characteristics of the signal that are either not easy to see or not visible at all at the time domain. The Fourier transform gives us the frequency domain representation of the synthetic signals I created. A spike at 1 kHz and a spike at 2 kHz. Now, I have created a third wave by just adding the first 2. And another wave, which you can immediately see that is different, but is also a combination of the first 2. A different combination. And the problem is that in the frequency domain, we're getting almost the same representation of them both, even though we see and can easily hear that they are totally different. So there are advantages in analyzing the signal at the time domain and advantages to the frequency domain. What I need is a representation that combines both the time and frequency information. And we can get it using short time Fourier transform, STFT. If we apply several FFTs at different time intervals, the result will be a spectrogram. You can think of it as many FFTs arranged next to each other. Each FFT is done for a small window of time. The spectrogram that you see here is a representation of a synthetic audio signal I created that sounds like that. The colors indicate the amplitude of strength of each frequency. The brighter the color, the higher the energy. And now we can clearly see how the frequency of the signal changes over time. So, both time and frequency representation. And this is the MFCC of that signal, I will not get into too many details, but you can see that it is not very different from the spectrogram representation. It's a different scale on the vertical axis. This is not a linear frequency scale, but rather a male scale, a scale of pitches that sounds to the human ear to be equal in distance from one another. The intensity scale is also nonlinear and also adjusted to the way our ears perceive audio intensity. Lots of materials on the internet if you'd like to understand more. The point is that now we have a representation that basically looks like an image, and this is something we can work with and feed into a neural network. So now we can extract the spectrogram of the audio signal and feed it into a CNN to generate feature map that could be used, for example, by a classifier to classify audio signals. Video 77, sound classification using the DL streamer or by a Python sample, is doing exactly that. Just YouTube OpenVINO 77. OpenVINO also has speech recognition demo. Look for that video. If you look at the demos and sample code, you can find libraries and functions that you can use to extract audio features, to efficiently extract MFCC and feed them into neural networks. This is it in a nutshell. There is a full world of knowledge out there. I don't usually do that, but I do recommend the Sound of AI channel by Valerio Velardo. He's just great. So, audio processing with OpenVINO. Go make some noises.